Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, Living in Canada. Today I want to continue talking about the IELTS test, but I won't talk about the contents of the test itself, but more about the logistical aspects, meaning what you need to prepare before you go and take the test and what other things you might need to think about. I also made another video earlier that talks about why I chose to take the computer-based test instead of the paper-based test. And if you haven't watched that yet, and if you are still thinking about whether to take the computer or paper-based test and can't decide, then maybe this video might help you. And I'll put the link above here, so go ahead and check it out. And I want to tell you up front that I took this test here in Toronto, in Ontario, Canada. So my experiences will be rather specific to that. But I would say that a lot of these things would also apply to the other IELTS test centers around the world. And also important here to note, I took the one that was held by the British Council, because the IELTS test is held by both the British Council and also IDP. So here I'm talking about the British Council and also specifically about the computer-based test. I had a really great experience taking the IELTS test here in Toronto that was held by the British Council. The people there were very friendly and very customer service oriented. One thing that is very important to bring that you must not forget is your passport, because they will identify you based on your passport. During registration, they will also ask you to double check some of your personal details on a sheet of paper, which includes the spelling of your name and your passport number. So you have to check that very carefully, and if everything is okay, then you just simply sign it. And the second thing I want to talk about is the time of your test and when you should come. You are advised by the IELTS Center to come, I think, about 15 minutes in advance. So you have to come there earlier so you can complete the registration process. But what I also found out from my recent experience is that you shouldn't come too early. I was so concerned that I would be late or have trouble finding the place. So that is why I arrived pretty early. I think I arrived about almost an hour in advance. I know, I always want to be really prepared. So when I got there, the IELTS representative asked me to just leave first and then come back again about half an hour before the test started. So I just went out again and got myself a drink and so on, and then I came back again. For obvious reasons, they just don't want too many people gathering together and be in close proximity. The next thing that you shouldn't forget to bring is your mask, and bring and wear a mask that is breathable, because what I found in the IELTS center where I took the test, I found that the air was a bit stuffy. I mean, they did try to ventilate the room. I think they opened the windows between each test so that the air would circulate, but still overall it felt kind of warm and stuffy. So make sure that you have a mask that covers your face properly as you need to, but at the same time that is maybe not too tight and that is really breathable, that you feel comfortable wearing, because you will be wearing that mask for a very long time. You have the speaking test, and then you have the listening, reading, and writing test, which is, I forgot exactly, 3 hours or so, and that's a very long time. So after you register, what will happen is that they will take a photo of you, and they will ask you to briefly take off your mask and then take a picture of you, like you would take a picture for a passport photo. And then you're practically done, and in the test center where I was, they gave me a plastic bag, like a huge transparent plastic bag, where I could put all of my belongings into. So basically my bag and also my jacket, I put everything in there, and then they took the bag and they stored it somewhere safe. So once I started with this, I started with a speaking test first, but some other people might start with a listening, reading, writing test first. But once you start the test, you will not be able to access your items. So usually there will be a time gap between your speaking test on one hand and then the other section, which is the listening, reading, writing test. And during each of these sections, you will not be able to access your items, but if in between there is time, then normally they would give you your items back, you collect them, and once you're about to start the next big section, then you will need to give them the items again. But within the listening, reading, writing section itself, you will not be able to access your items. But anyway, you won't really be needing any of that because there is nothing that you really need for the computer-based test. You do not need to bring a pen or paper. During the test, they will actually give you a pen or a pencil to make some scribbles and notes, and they will also give you a piece of paper to make notes. This piece of paper is basically a piece of paper where it has the login details because you will need to log into your computer to do the test. I'll explain about that later. So you can just use that paper and the backside to make your notes. Now let's talk about water and snack. I know in total you'll be there at the center for such a long time. At least I felt it was a really long time. So you will want to make sure that you are properly hydrated and that you also had some food before that. I brought some snacks with me. I brought some walnuts. So right before I got into the testing room, I just ate some of those because I really hate it when I'm working on something, focusing on something, and my stomach starts growling. So it is a good idea to bring a snack with you, but of course you won't be able to bring that food inside the test center. And also make sure that you're properly hydrated and bring some water with you. And this is a very important note. If you want to be able to bring your water bottle into the testing room, then make sure that it's firstly transparent and also that it doesn't have any sticker or so on. If it has some sticker with a branding on it, then simply remove it. Also make sure that you don't drink too much because you don't want to be in a situation where you need to go back and forth to the bathroom all of the time. And you are able to go to the bathroom during the test, and the IELTS representative will also let you know exactly when you are allowed to go to the bathroom. But I simply find it a bit disruptive if during the test, in the middle of the test, I need to step out to go to the bathroom and go back. It just like messes with my concentration. So it's a good idea not to drink too much. So hopefully you won't need to go to the bathroom during the test. So next, just a few minutes before the official test starts, everyone will go into the room and will be shown to their seats. So you take a seat there, and you can adjust the height of your chair, and you can also adjust your screens, the tilt of your screen, and they will show you how. At least that was the case in the center that I went to here in Toronto. They were really, really nice and took the time to explain everything to us. And then they would read some of the rules, like that you can't cheat and everything, obviously, and some of the instructions. And you will be given time to test the headset. So they have these headsets that you put on, and then you will be able to test the volume and everything. So if you find that it's too soft, you can increase the volume or you can decrease it and so on. And then when the official test starts, in the beginning, what you see on your screen is just a blank screen with a place for your login details. And at first when I sat down, I was thinking, what are my login details? I don't know what my login details are. Did I forget to bring something? But that was not the case. So what happens is that for each of these sections, listening, reading, and writing, the IELTS representative will go around and hand you out a sheet that contains your individual logins for that particular section. So for example, for the listening section, you get one sheet with your logins, and then you are advised to put in those details, and then they will tell you when to start the test. And on that same sheet, like I mentioned before, you are allowed to make notes. So you can, while doing the listening test and the other tests, you can just scribble down your notes and then transfer your results to the computer. But I didn't really make that much use of this sheet. And also, as for the paper-based test, after the end of that section, they will come and collect your sheet. They will take it back. And for the next section, they will give you a new sheet with new login details for that particular section. I just have one small tip about this login sheet, this sheet to scribble your notes. So I didn't make any notes on that sheet about my answers for the test, but what I did is that I scribbled notes for time management. I think this is such an important thing that is underestimated. So it's so important to plan your time properly because your time is limited and the clock is ticking. So before I start any of these tests, I roughly jot down how much time I will take per question. I simply look at the number of questions and the time that I have, and then I subtract about 15 minutes of time for myself so I can review the questions and answers in the end and make sure I have enough time for that. And the remaining time, I divide by the number of questions. So by doing this, I set myself my own time limit to answer each of these questions so I don't go over time, because what can happen if you don't do this is that you spend too much time on one section and then you find out that you only have 15 minutes left but you still have 20 questions to answer. One more tip that I want to share with you is about clothing. Yes. No, it's not the case that anyone cares about what you're wearing, but I personally found it very warm inside. Right now in Canada, it's super cold outside. It's like around minus 10 degrees today. But that day during the test, inside that small room with the other participants, I found it pretty warm. And I had like quite thick sweater on. So I would advise you to, on that day when you go to the test, to have several layers on. For example, have a long shirt sleeve on and then maybe a hoodie on it. So when you are about to start the test, before you go into the testing room, you can like have a feel about, is this too warm or too cold? If you find it too warm, then you can just simply take off your hoodie. But if you are already stuck with this huge, big, hot sweater, then you won't be able to make any adjustments, right? So that is just one small tip that I wanted to give you. So that was it about the IELTS test. Let me know if you have any other questions about this and also about living, working, and studying in Canada in general. Feel free and drop them in the comments below and I'll try my best to get to them and answer them. Thank you so much for watching and I'll talk to you again soon.